Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's a Wavetek model 1001A. It's a sweep signal generator. This is actually a little bit interesting because the frequency range of the RF output goes from, it looks like it's zero, but it is a half a megahertz and all the way to 300 megahertz. I don't know if that is easy to read. Here you go. And that will be the output level. Then you can set the sweep time, how fast it is, and you can also set how wide is the sweep. And if you go like click, you go in CV, that's constant wave. So then it's just a signal generator, right? And we've got some markers we can enable, more or less of those. And then demodulation input. Haven't yet figured out what that is. I got this recently at a flea market, and of course I paid a little bit too much for this one, but I got a lot of other things real cheap, so I thought, well, what the, you win some, you lose some, right? So let's look a little bit at the rear. We got a remote. I think this is just start stopping and syncing and all that kind of stuff. And of course we got scope for horizontal and vertical, so we can do sweep. External marker and pin lift option. Aha! I feel I need to open it before I power it up, because what if it's just real bad? You better have a look. It is really beautiful inside. Look at all those shielded cases with nice labels. So we got something here with like 0.1 megahertz, 1 megahertz, some other megahertz, and 10 megahertz, and some 50 megahertz. So that's probably some different markers. And then see, we go in here to a marker adder. So all the O's, they will be added. And then you can enable the different markers on the switches. That is at least how I think it works. Then we got an oscillator mixer, and that mixes together with the markers. And we got an output amplifier, sweep rate. Ooh, and you can adjust all sorts of cool things. And then there is a sweep drive. The output attenuator, of course. Nice BNC connectors. So, I mean, if this whole thing just blows up, or if it's absolutely impossible to repair, then I see immediately here is a cool spare part to save for the future. And here is the power supply, and that one looks quite all right. This is a, well, it's not super vintage, it's 1977 technology. At least the manual I was able to find was from 1977, but I see here 73 on that one. And is that 70, also 73? So maybe this unit is a little bit older. The bottom here is quite thick and stable, this material here. Maybe it's, I don't know, tint or silvered steel. I'm not super happy about cutting sharp holes like this and just having cables going around sharp metal cuts like that. Always, I really prefer always to have some sort of a plastic fitting in between here, or a little rubber thing. So that will be the interconnects. It looks a little bit like we could probably unscrew a module and disconnect it. It looks like sockets. I don't know yet, but Look at that, is some sort of a click in and then a screw. I definitely feel like I should try and take one of the modules out for inspection, just to see the kind of build quality or the build level of this. But as it is right now, I feel like I could power it up. It is should be safe to power it up. See, there's a little message here. A radio amateur call sign and then 10:08. So is this month or year? So it's probably tested in 08. So that is some years ago. I am now ready for the first power up. Mains is applied and nothing bad happened. Oi, oi, oi. Look at that. We got output. And that, I put it in CV mode intentionally. And took, What is that? Is 311, it says. And I put it for 300. Oh, let's crank it all the way up. And it goes to 334. And let's see. Okay, let me show you guys. Ah, the output is... Yeah, well, it's not super compensated. Or maybe it's just me poking around here. Let me do like that and tick tick here. So that is 78 megahertz. Let me try and see how good the scale is here. 100. 91. Okay, not too bad. Let's go. Ooh. That is 16. Oh, so there's some, yes, of course there is. There is some sort of a mixer. Oh, that is, of course, how it works. I got it. Yeah. Okay, so there is a fixed oscillator and another variable oscillator, and then they're mixed together, and this is why we have a zero beat around here, and then it actually goes to, yips. See, here you go. Yeah. Okay, no big surprise. But now we know at least how it works. And let's try something funny, okay? So I've now put it into 100 megahertz. Let's try this sweep. So this is sweep with. Ah, manual, okay. Oh, look at that. It is sweeping. It definitely worked. Oop. What happened? Oh, you need to restart it. Oh dear. What is this one doing? Ah, that is speed as well. Okay. Aha. And then variable. It really works. That looks so nice. I totally love it. And of course go really fast. And then how about those markers? How's that working? I need to play a little bit with this, I guess. I need to show you guys this. This is really funny. So, of course, the RF output and the demodulation input. So, imagine you feed this signal to some sort of a filter or something that is frequency dependent. I just took a random crystal and a diode, and then I put the signal into the demodulation input. Okay, so this, at least something should happen, right? And then of course I'm playing a little bit with the sweep width and markers and all that kind of stuff. So now I am using the horizontal and the vertical outputs on the back, feed them into a scope, and let's have a look at what is going on. So first we play in normal time mode. Okay, so this is the purple one here is the sweep. That is the horizontal output from this sweep generator. and the yellow one, that is of course the signal. And you see the signal is following the sweeped. So this is the sweep frequency is changing, and it's doing all sorts of stuff. And then here's my crystal that is reacting to the sweep. So if I change the frequency, it goes like this. And if I change the sweep width, it's doing like this. So I can have a lot more or a lot less, or move it around and all that kind of stuff. Of course, the attenuator is here, so I can adjust the level I want. And then the markers, let me take, I don't know, it's easy to see, but we see some weak markers. I can have them more powerful, or I can change the width. I think it's not that easy to see because I am driving the input quite powerful, but if I crank down the level, now you can see the markers. They're not supposed to be very very powerful in the image or something like that. Here we go. And then I can adjust all sorts of stuff. Yeah, so we've got some different markers that's coming at different frequencies depending on what kind of marker switches I push. Okay, so far so good. So let's try and do the same in XY mode. Okay, I'll turn off the markers. So here we go. Now we are in XY mode, and we can play a little bit with the amplitude. So what we have made here is actually a spectrum analyzer, more or less. I don't know if you can see this, but this is how I see it. I can adjust all the sweeps and all that kind of stuff. And here we go with the markers. I don't know if that is how they're supposed to be. I was expecting some nice little shiny dots, but I think I'm using this wrong. Oh, here we go. That we got some little markers, and then I can adjust some. I don't know exactly what I'm doing here, but let me see. If I zoom in, you can see those markers, right? Or if I crank up the signal, yes, exactly. Here we go. Now we can see some markers, and of course the idea is you can just count how many and all that kind of stuff. So if I change the sweep, see, that is the sweep frequency. But if I change the sweep width, you see, the markers, they follow. And this is how you calibrate the measurement like this. Then I can, of course, poke around with this until I get the markers exactly to line up. Oops. See? With the scope divisions. And then you can use this to measure exactly this and this frequency, and this is where it peaks and whatnot. So in 1977, this was definitely a cool thing to analyze components, filters, all sorts of parts that changed behavior versus frequency. Getting one of the modules out here was actually quite easy. We got some screws down here that go through. We got connectors. It's quite easy to unscrew this, and it's marked here in this case with A and B. And they go here, A and B. So, I mean, it should be possible to assemble this again, right? So how are we going inside this box to have a little look? I think maybe I could unscrew these. I also got a little bit of handwriting here. I need to figure this out. Maybe unscrew all these, and then it's all coming out. So this is probably also a part of holding everything together, right? Yeah, and this is a little bit how you're doing it. To begin with, I thought I could just unscrew these two and then take this out, and then maybe, I don't know, what I thought. But as you see, this is the kind of feeling I got, so oops, that was not it. Of course, I didn't try with the other one then. So the trick is, of course, to remove the three nuts and then pull everything out of the case. So that is the trick. And look, the modules, they are made super, super handmade. Oh, this is nice. It's full of transistors and goodies. Got three little transistors up here and oh my goodness, that is lovely. And here is one of the big 2-in-1 FETs or transistors. And this is a very good thermal design. See all the transistors? You stick them through holes and give them a little solder drop. Oh, this is lovely. And then these little standoffs here, they are Teflon and some are ceramics. This is just beautiful. And all the in-outs here, that's probably feed through. Yeah, you see some values here, so that is nice, nice. I don't want to open these because you need to. So we've got two different oscillators and they are beating together, right? I mean, if I have a little, and here is a mixer. Yips, here we go. I mean, if I have a little look inside this oscillator, don't you think that will be enough to satisfy my curiosity for tonight, I guess, just to see what kind of lovely stuff is in here. And this is the thing you can do with a Metcal. It's just gonna take anything, how thick the metal is, it's just gonna solder on it. So there's not a lot of, ooh, there is actually a little bit of sexiness left in here. Oh, look at that. So here's the signal that just goes in and out. Ooh, and then it's picked up by some of this stuff. That is so nice. I really love it. But anyway, I'm not going to take out all the different boxes and have a look inside all of them. I expect them to be more or less just as sexy, more or less the same kind of design and stuff like that. And I think we're just going to leave it like that, right? You get the point, you get the idea, you had fun. And see you tomorrow, okay? Bye.